Hey guys, Jeff back with another Hep Ahead beer review. Sad day, and yet happy day at the same time. I guess you could say bittersweet. I knew this day was going to come, and we've come to the end of our journey. What journey am I talking about? I'm, of course, talking about the end of our monster beer tour from Terrapin. And the conclusion is none other than their Wake and Bake Coffee Oatmeal Imperial Stout. This is the last one that I have yet to review, and it also is my favorite, so what do you know? I think they are releasing a new one next year, so we'll have to pick it up from there, but for the time being, this is the end of the 2011 Monster Beer Tour. I'll read the description right here. It says, two Athens, Georgia companies, Terrapin and Jittery Joe's, have teamed up to create a unique blend of coffee used to produce this robust and flavorful beer. So when it comes to a morning beverage, why not beer? And it's brewed with the Wake and Bake, I guess is what they call their coffee, so that's what they called the beer for a while, but this year they changed it, and then now it just says a WNB, so I don't know if people took it as a drug reference or what it was, but they stopped calling it now. So I guess it's just Coffee Oatmeal Imperial Stout. But it's 8.1% double American stout. And I've had this twice on tap. I had the 2010 on tap and the 2011 on tap. I've yet to have it from a bottle, but I'm super excited about it. So let's go ahead and get into it. Normal Terrapin cap. Pretty cool though. I like those a lot. Really looking forward for the Moohoo to come out. Haven't seen it yet, though. All right, let's see what we got here. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That is beautiful looking. Look at that head. It's only about a finger, but it's a nice mocha color. It's got some nice tight bubbles. You got a lot of carbonation going on the bottom, and it's just black as death. Is that a thing? We'll just say black as night. It's got some good alcohol legs, a little bit, not too much there, but we'll see how the lacing goes as we get into this. And again, this is pretty cold. I took it right out of the refrigerator because I wanted to see how it would develop as it got warmer, but I know that you are supposed to serve it warm, so we'll definitely do that, but let's go ahead and get into it. Really, when you smell this for the first time, you just get punched in the face with coffee. Just dark espresso notes, just really earthy coffee notes. A little bit of toffee, caramel, that kind of thing. I'm not getting too much oatmeal, but really just coffee and roasted malt. And it really just smells delicious. Yeah, that's all I can say about it. So let's go ahead and give it a taste. Cheers. That's a good beer. Really ridiculously smooth, full-bodied beer. Yeah, initially you're just getting some nice, sweet, roasted malt. Maybe some dark chocolate notes, and then at the end you're just getting that bitter coffee, and it kind of sticks on the tongue a little bit. But it's not like annoying or cloying with sweetness. Well, I guess it's bitter. It's not really. But yeah, so this is just, it's an incredible beer. Oh God, it's so good. I'm drinking it way too fast. I need to let it chill or warm up, I guess. All right, so really good so far. It'll only get better as it warms up. So we'll come back in about 15 minutes when it's warmed up a little bit and give you my second opinion and final opinion. See you guys in a little bit. Alright guys, and we're back. It's been about 15 minutes and it's warmed up some. Still a little cool, but it's not 10-point Russian Imperial Stout or anything, so I don't think that any hops or anything are going to come through if I let it warm up to about room temperature, but it is 50 degrees or so. So let's go ahead and give it another smell. I mean, it still smells delicious. You're still getting the intense coffee, but the coffee has mellowed some. And it is blending with some of the other smells, or some of the, yeah, some of the other senses pretty well. You're still getting some of that bitter, sweet chocolate from some of the malts that they use, and you're getting, some, of course, the roasted malts and the toffee, caramel, that kind of a smell. I don't know if I just haven't had something that's just like in your face oatmeal, but I can't discern that smell from anything else. But it's still just an amazing smelling beer, so let's give it another taste. Yeah, that's so good. And when it warms up, it even smooths out some than it did before. You're still left with that the nice bittering on your tongue. The coffee flavor is kind of hanging around, but and even though it does have a lot of coffee flavor. I don't think that for someone that disliked the flavor of coffee, I don't think that this would be very off-putting because it blends so well with the other flavors that are going on in this. So I'll give one more taste. Yeah, that's amazingly smooth, and just the coffee and the oatmeal flavors balance with the roasted malt perfectly, and there's nothing that's really dominating the other one. There's really nothing off-putting about it. When it warms up, you're getting like a slight hint of alcohol. You can tell that it's there, but it's really not bad at all. And it's only 8.1%, so it's not like you're not getting any fusel alcohol smells or tastes or anything. It's really just a great beer. So this concludes our Monster Beer Tour from Terrapin. I'm going to say that this is my favorite beer from Terrapin's Monster Beer Tour. I really think that this beer can't be beat. I love it. I kind of wish that it was more available, or maybe available year-round. I think it's already sold. I can't find it anymore in Raleigh. I only picked up one 4-pack. So I drink one. I had it on tap, and I think that as much as I don't want to do this because I want to just drink it all, but I'm gonna age the other three, and then we'll see in the future how they turn out. But I have some aged breakfast stout, and I did a review of that, but it was really well. So that's another coffee oatmeal stout, and that one aged pretty well. So we'll see how this one does. Gonna give this one an A. I'm gonna give it a 97. Actually, which might be my highest score yet, but I really love this beer, and it will always hold a special place in my heart. All right, enough of that. So to recap, I'm going to say that this is my favorite of the Monster Beer Tour, second being Gamma Ray, and then last place is their Monk's Revenge, where they blend the Saison and the Belgian IPA. I just think that those flavors don't really mesh well in that beer. But everything that they got going on with this beer works really well. And it's an A. If you can find it, definitely pick up probably 3 or 4 4-packs, because I think 1 or 2 isn't going to be enough because it is that good. So until next year, we are done with the Terrapin Monster Beer Tour. But we are not done with Terrapin at all, because they're still one of my favorite breweries, and there's still plenty more to do, especially their Moohoo, which is coming out soon. But catch you guys next time. Check it out. Terrapin Way You Can Bake. Peace.